This is to a doggy man's race complete. Return, sweet child, to whence you came, but stay with me first for a while. In this cold room, together, our warmth will house us grief and denial. Let the wind be your home now. I hear you in the leaves, while I return to the home we shared, and with your spirit greet. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Audra, and today I would like to share with you my poem, Residing in My Veins. My inspiration and process behind this poem was aimed to create a poem that kind of like displayed the intimate connection that we have, like with the spiritual and physical aspects of like a relationship. So I relied heavily on visual imagery. I feel like as humans, we struggle to fully comprehend our partner's thoughts, feelings, and emotions. And sometimes the only way you can truly get to know someone is through the symbolic or the metaphorical. So that is what I strove to do with this poem. An inhalation of love ignites your fragile chest, radiant as it lifts between the cracks in your ribs, calling me deeper, summoning me home, to live in the diaphanous membrane of your lungs, inviting me to swim through pools of crimson blood, pumping existence into the galaxy of your mind. Caged by a web of stars and interwoven dreams, I must traverse until I am permitted to settle deep in the marrow of your aching bones, the only true home I was ever destined for. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I wanted to talk more so about the inspiration behind my poem. And it's centered around the national flower of the Philippines, which is the sapodita. I wanted to incorporate this into the experiences of my beautiful mother. And she left her home and family in order to come to America. And I thought, who better represents something so soft and beautiful, but also something that stands firm and tall. Not only does it represent my mother, but also the many inspiring Filipino men and women and ancestors I come from who sacrificed to help me make it this far. My poem is called, I'm a Daughter Who Misses Her Parents. She's made of bones and the softness of a sapodita flower. She's made of the experiences of her tatam sacrifices. She stood on the mountain of dreams she began building for her daughters and made it into America despite how painful it was. She is two worlds in one, and she cannot define home because she made it all of
her own. Hi, my name is Isabella, and I just want to talk real quick about my inspiration for this poem. So when I thought about the theme of home, the first thing that came to my mind was childhood. And even though I had a really nice childhood and a home with people who loved me, I realized that not everybody has that. Sometimes we can grow up in one place our whole lives, but other times we have to be moved, we might lose our home forever. So I wrote this for the people who may not see their homes anymore, or who may have painful memories. And it's called, Who Sings in My Childhood Home? Never too far away, it lies within my mind and heart. Although desecrated by pain, although desecrated by tears, it remains as my burial ground. Withering under budding flowers, harboring my youth, cradling my soul.
So my inspiration is my childhood. I grew up in coastal Southern California, and though we lived in a beautiful geographic area, our home life was full of upheaval and violence. Frequently evicted, we moved several times a year, and we were occasionally homeless. I found solace from the constants of the beach and the ocean, swearing I would never leave them. But years later, my husband and I moved to Clovis, and to my surprise, found a sense of stability and peace I never thought possible. I fell in love with the great Central Valley, finding community and healing here. So I just wanted to tell that story of how I found home using the imagery of geography as just to portray that and as lead characters in the poem. So I have two versions. One is a little bit longer, the other is shortened to fit into the art song structure. This is called Unearthing. Sand grit thrashed, cyan sea where I was born. Coastal path stranded me, while quaking earth tumulted my bones. Slippage of plates tectonic and familial. My plot 7
one simple word, and that is interconnectedness. Interconnectedness in the fact that, you know, when we think of a tune, we can write a tune and we write an accompaniment for it, we have lyrics. And they kind of, it's kind of, oh, the tune is nice, the melody is nice, the accompaniment is nice. But it's not that way with art song. Art song, you have to pay attention to every detail. The lyric, the melody, the accompaniment are all woven together. They are interconnected. And I think we carry on that thing by working with the poetry department, the interconnectedness between these creatives. And I love the idea of a community of interconnected artists and creatives and humanists who are making this world a better place through art and beauty and music. And so I have the distinct honor of announcing the judges' prize, the winner of the 6th annual Fresno State Art Song Festival. We had several wonderful participants. But out of some very, very difficult choices to make, the judges have selected as the winner for this year for the 6th annual Fresno State Art Song Festival, Marcus Overacker. Wonderful composers, many of whom I have the honor of teaching, Nathaniel Morris. Come on down. sweet.